describe what it was like for you. Tell us what happened. Yeah. How it started.
Yeah. The first time I was in demonstration, just because it was funny to be with a lot of people in Syria.
You were demonstrating.
Yeah. I was 15 years old and people was in big demonstration, 40,000 people. And for me, it was fun. I had no idea what democracy means or dictatorship means. I was just a child. So I just followed these people and this the security on the other side. And I was a child thinking about the police protect us, as we read in the books and we know on the TV. So, but the police was shooting people for the first time and my best friend died next to me and they arrested me from the demonstration. So they put me in prison for 2 days for the first time.
So they arrest you during the demonstration and then they put you in prison and it's just 2 days. What
happens? 2 days for the first time. I was arrested 7 different times. The last time was 3 years, between 17 and 20. So I get out of prison when I was 20 years old, lost my memory, was 34 kilos because of the starvation in prison and the torture. We had like, our life in prison was 4 hours to sleep, 4 hours of torture, 2 hours between you're eating your food and going to the toilet when you have 35 meters to the right, to the left. You have a lot of guards torturing you the whole way and you have 10 seconds. Someone is counting outside the door. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. And you should get out of the toilet after 10 seconds. And then you go back to your cell and you have 40 centimeters square and you sit down. There is no walls. The walls is people sitting next to you. And the person to the right is the psychologist, and here is a doctor and engineer behind you. Well-educated people.
4 hours of torture a day.
Long time.
What is the torture?
The torture, it depends on which time is it. Are you new in prison or not? Because when you're new in prison, they start with taking out your nails. Then they use...
Taking out your fingernails.
Yeah, exactly. Then they use the electricity almost all the days.
Electricity, and, they shock you.
Yeah, absolutely. They do that. They have a systematic way to torture people. They know. And they torture you with the starvation and other way of torture when they give you a lot of food, but you're not allowed to eat. You just can't look at the food and they put the food outside the room when you're extremely hungry.
They're trying to break you psychologically.
Yeah, it's really important for them to break you psychologically. So they don't want people to think about getting out because in case people have food to eat, they're going to think about freedom. But when people is hungry, they're gonna think about food, only food.
So they beat you a lot. You talk about that in an extraordinary TED talk. You hear them beating other people. Throughout this process, you lose essentially your entire family, right? Inside and outside of the prisons.
Yeah, I was arrested with 3 cousins. Two of them died in front of my eyes. One of them died in my arms. And the third one was a female cousin as the same age as me. But I heard she was killed, but I had no, I was not sure. Then there was a new cousin who told me that they killed whole my family. But then when I get out
They killed
prison,
your family in a massacre, right?
A massacre
outside.
In my village, Albaida, where like people was only demonstrating like with the flowers, getting out of the demonstration with flowers, just asking for freedom or just, For better life, nothing else. They killed people for that reason.
Why were you released?
I was released. This was a lawyer. Get into prison, had a good contact with an officer, paid money, and get me out and communicate with my mother, said, I have your son. If you pay money, you get your son. So
and
my
mother
paid money to get me, so my mother paid me at that time.
There's something happening here right now in the U.S. as we're looking towards the 2020 presidential elections. One of the Democratic presidential candidates, Tulsi Gabbard, who met with Bashar al-Assad in 2017, was just asked at one of our CNN town halls if Assad is a war criminal. And here's what she said.
I think that the evidence needs to be gathered. And as I have said before, if there is evidence that he has committed war crimes, he should be prosecuted as such.
But you're not sure now.
Everything that I have said requires that we take action based on evidence. The evidence is there. There should be accountability.
She won't say, has not said, that he committed war crimes. She won't call him a war criminal. How do you respond to that?
There is a lot of evidence. There is the wounds in my body. There is a lot of, like, not a lot, but there is survivors can tell you about prison. How many people are being killed? I have a video of my father being killed. There is a lot of evidence, a lot of videos, a lot of documentary. There is everything.
What happens when politicians here will not, even depending on whatever they want to see with the policy in the Middle East, but they will not say what is happening? What does that do for people in Syria like you, like your friends who may still be there, and what does that do for the legitimacy of the regime?
For the first thing, as from prisoners, the first thing that we think about when we're in prison, no one think about us, no one care, so we die in silence. And the same thing with other people in the war in Syria. They know no one is caring. Why people don't do that? Do you think I deserve to survive? If you think I do, other people do as well. Why you today look at me? Some people look at me and say, you deserve to get help. But you don't do any, I don't need help right now, but there is other people need. Why you don't do anything? One time they thought I died. They put me in this room. I wake up with all dead bodies and the door was closed. I should just waked up like it was an arm over my head. So they could look at that body. Someone is dead and his eyes is open. I should do something, move. Just try to take myself to the door, connect the door. And someone opened the door and said, what are you doing here? I said, I still alive. And he said, why? You should die.